And that never went away.
And in terms of Brian, is there much fans who have been out here like looking forward to seeing you and seeing this movie, man?
This is fantastic, and we are so thankful that all these people came out tonight. And we hope that you enjoy the movie as much as we did making it.
The product, and just how excited are you for everyone to see this movie? How proud of you of this movie are you?
I think it is exponentially more ridiculous than the first, and I hope everybody agrees with that.
Steve Carell, always lovely to see you. Thank you so much, mate.
Thank you so much.
And then you go shoot the movie, you're in an edit room for 6 months, and then boom, you're out here in the middle of this crowd with this energy. It's amazing. It's thrilling.
And obviously, you've turned in another hilarious film. I've seen it. It's brilliant. Were there any nerves, though, about recreating the lightning in the bottle that was the first Anchorman?
I always say, you know, the spirit of Anchorman is sort of like falling down the stairs. It's impossible to have nerves. You just take a crazy tumble and bang your head a few times and you're done. So there's no real room to be nervous. We're all laughing too hard and flying by the seat of our pants.
Now, I've obviously seen you work, and you get as involved in the cast improv as they do, shouting live.
Dreaming each dream on your own.
This movie.
I think Adam described it best when it was a horror show every day.
Because it is such a funny movie. Is it really as funny making the film as it is watching it?
Yes, every day there'll be something amazing.
So long to be here at the premiere with so many people shouting whammy at you. How does that actually feel?
It feels great. It feels great.
And finally, what is in store for people from this movie? What can people look forward to?
They won't be disappointed. They're going to love it.
Fantastic stuff. David, have a great night, man.
Cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm joined now by Megan Good. Megan, fantastic to have you here in London. How was your walk down our burgundy carpet this evening?
Oh, man, it was awesome. It was super exciting.
Fantastic. Now, you're obviously a new character in the Anchorman universe. You play Linda Jackson. Tell us a bit about her relationship to the news team.
Oh, man. Linda is the boss. She's the head honcho. She's very tough, very aggressive, in an unlikely position as a woman at that time. And so because of that, she's very strong, and you're going to do what she tells you to do, or else there's going to be a problem, and you don't want that. So,
how did you personally find the atmosphere working on the set of an Anchorman movie?
It was such a good set and good experience. Everybody is so nurturing and.
Still, somehow, I believe we always survive.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with none other for this sequel. How pleased are you to actually be standing here with the movie in the can with such a positive reaction already?
We're just excited because we've seen the movie. We really like it. It came out great. I think it sets funnier than the first one. And now we could just enjoy everyone getting to see it.
To take you back to the first movie.
The warmth for each other, and it shows in the movie. They like each other. Except for the one person we hate, who we won't mention now.
All right, the big question. What is in store for the fans of Anchor? That's a perfect way to end. John Abbott, thank you so much, man. Ladies and gentlemen, joining me now on stage at the UK premiere of Anchorman 2 is Mr. Paul Rudd. Mr. Paul Rudd, how you doing?
I'm...
But that love combined with the fact it must be a great feeling to be standing here in London at the premiere of Anchorman 2 after so long waiting for this.
It's unbelievable. It's an amazing experience. I've never been to a premiere in Leicester Square. I've seen pictures of it. I've seen clips of it on the news for other films. So that we're here for this film and that.
Fantastic stuff.
Not anymore. Now I'm like, I'm sleeping in, guy.
And listen. What do you make of this wonderful London reception?
You guys are setting the bar pretty high. New York is in a few days, and I've never seen anything like this before. So well done. Well done, and thank you.
You're very kind. Now, obviously, you're new to the world of Anchorman. You play Jack Lime. Tell us a little bit about Jack.
Well, Jack is the hotshot news anchor at the 24-hour news station where the boys from San Diego come in to join. And immediately, he's a bit of a schoolyard bully. He picks Ron out and just decides to be relentless. And they start, you know, they start posturing and pounding their chests, and it becomes a battle of will. Try not to think about it too much, otherwise I'd get a little nervous. But I actually, it was just excitement. Really, I was obviously a fan of the first one. I auditioned for the first movie, and to come, you know, back now and be a part of this one is pretty special.
With the man who has directed this movie, and of course the first Anchorman, it's director Adam McKay.
It's Judd Apatow is here taking pictures? I mean, what beats that? I like when my paparazzi is a one-man gang of Judd Apatow.
Now, obviously, you've worked on loads of movies.
Arrested, gonna do some time. He got out 3 years from now just to commit more crime. A businessman is caught with 24 kilos. He's out on bail and out of jail, and that's the way it goes. Athletes rejected, governors.